Hello everyone, it's time to spend the night in the woods. So welcome to Longest Night. How do I get this thing started? There it is. Oh snaps, it's the whole gang again. Why aren't I cold? Fire, we have a fire. We have reached that level as a civilization. Oh. I'm bored. Feels like we've been here forever. Oh, we should do the Longest Night constellation thing. Wow, really? I haven't done that since I was like 6. No one has done that since they were like 6. Well, I don't remember being 6. Really? Really? Yeah, I don't remember much before like 8 and a half. Wow, that's very specific. B is a synthetic life form created at age 8.5. This makes so much sense. Beep boop beep. 11011. Okay, whatever, I'm done. Can we just do this thing? None of us knows enough about the constellations to even do it, B. Yeah, B. Oh, really? Aha! I knew it. I remember Angus knowing about that because May told him. But apparently he doesn't remember this being a thing. Which is why I am playing this right now. Since when? Since always. Now listen up, dummies. We're going to school. Space school. Oh, snaps. I can't see anything. You will soon, Señorita. We're pattern finders. Find some patterns. Well, snaps. I guess we're gonna start with this. Oh, I got a clicky. Ah, it's a good thing I could kind of see the layout. Bam! Got ourselves a pattern. Rubello, Pope sometime in the 1400s. Crazy times. Oh god, I love this one. There were two rival popes. And Rubello won by opening his mouth. And consuming them with fire. What the? Okay, I was not expecting that. And then he ate them. Yeah, I was not seeing that either. What? Wah! I knew that one. That is amazing. I mean historically, his extended family poisoned one. What the? And stabbed the other before throwing him into a canal. But he did eat them. He did eat them, yes. Oh, I thought he was joking about that. That is the reddest thing I have ever heard. Chomp chomp. Whoops, I ate you. Now I'm the Pope. And now it's time to find more of them stars. Let's gather them, put them together. Tell us another story, Angus. Tell us a really good one. Ooh. Harmonium? The head of the singing orders of angels. Ugh, this one. My mom always said I look like this one. I can see it. I sure can't. Leading so many cranky angels. Crouching hard. She's like, got nothing to say about that. Across the sky. Okay. Moving on. Oh, that's it. Let's see, how about this big giant thing? I know this is gonna be a giant. Dang, this thing is huge. Oops. There we go. Oh! It's that whale! Mundi, the world fish. Back then, they thought whales were fish. And you know, that world was on one. Mundi is my sign. Oh god. Of course it is. Hey, what does that mean? Worm. Worm. Well, if any of this meant anything, then it might mean something, but it doesn't so. It doesn't. Whoa. What are you doing? Whale noises. I had a feeling that's what that was. I'm not good at doing whale noises, so. Alright. Is this supposed to be just three? Aha, it is. Tolmetron. It rings at the end of the world. And Mundy shakes everything off her back. And I think it all catches fire, too. It all made sense back then. Back when people were, like, wicked dumb. Yeah, I don't mean to sound like a jerk, but people were super dumb back then. It's all relative. And full of dumb people. Beautiful dumb people. Okie dokie. Yeah, it's a good thing we don't live in those times. Oh, that was easy. A fish. And? What about it? Just a fish. Pretty self-explanatory. Huh. Fun fact, fish is my sign. I think that means you're adaptable and smelly. Let's see, I think that means you're a failure in all things. Let's try the first one. Got one of those right, huh, Captain? Got a manly musk going on here. You smell like that stuff I've got you, finally. Ice hawk. It has a picture of an ice hawk on it. I smell quite masculine. Like an ice hawk. I think you smell nice, Angus. Thanks. What's an ice hawk? Who knows, Senorita? I have no idea. Let's see. This is a long one. Oh! Ah! Clicky! Oh, this doesn't go? Oh, I was doing it wrong. Okay, that makes sense. Oh, I'm still doing it wrong? Uh-oh. What am I missing? Is this cool hit? What the? Why can't I put this together? Huh. I give up. I got lost with that one. Let's try that one. Quinona. Executed by some king somewhere. Well, her head continued to speak against her murderers for years. That's pretty sweet. Ugh, you'd think, right? But in the story, she's portrayed as annoying. Like she was being a martyr? I can't say that word. I don't know why. Leave me alone. Don't make fun of me. Never mind, you can. Whatever. About literally being Marty something. They eventually put her head in a trunk and threw it in a river. Jeez. What did she do? Talked out loud in public. Oh, is that all? That was enough, apparently. Supposedly, if you put your head underwater in some river in Italy, she'll tell you about her murder. They renamed it the River of Guilt. But not like the guilt of her murderers. More like she's giving you a guilt trip or something stupid. This constellation is garbage. Chop my head off, I'll bite yours off. Happy longest night, everyone. Moving on. So why can't I put this together? That is so strange, but I'm just gonna move on. Maybe I'll be able to get to it some point. There we go. Lucio. Aw, yeah. Who? What? Who is that? Lucio, the fox. They had to spear him to the ground to keep him down. Wait, keep him down? How so? You know, in general. You can see why this one is so popular. I don't understand, but okay. I'm gonna take your word for it. Ooh, look at that. Marmanodes? The little king. He was, a king who was little? I don't know anything about this one. Apparently a little king was big news back then. I don't think he was even supposed to be all that small. Stop the presses. So there's this king, right? But get this, he's slightly smaller than you expect. He wears small shoes. Let's immortalize him in the night sky. I'm kind of short. Maybaroski constellation. Nah, everyone who picked the constellations is dead now. Interesting. I'm sad that I cannot put this together. Why can't I put it? Wait, what the? Whoa! That's why. Interesting. Inverus. Inverus. Inverus, the inventor of music. Nice beak. Reminds me of Germ. Oh, yeah. Haha. Germ isn't even musical, like, at all. Who? Germ? Like Germ? Weird Germ? Yes? How do you know? I think May's getting sleepy. Alright, moving on to the next one. We're getting close to all of them, I think. Let's see, is this connected? No, it's not. What is this? Whoa, Ibon, the first singer. Interesting. Tell me more. Ever see the opera based on this? Nope. Oh yeah. How about... Nope. Oh, it's brilliant. It's like 21 hours long. Whoa. And like 100 years ago when it was playing in Bright Harbor, the stage exploded during the part where Ibon crashes his balloon into the world worm. Sweet. Was anyone killed? Like, a lot of people. Oh. Listen, if you can't laugh at that, I have bad news about the rest of history. Yeah, that doesn't sound good at all. Let's see. Is this connected? No? Oh, maybe that's why. The mice writers. Inventors of written language. Weren't there supposed to be thousands of them? Listen, there's only so much sky. The mice writers are my sign. Cool. I think that means you're thousands of geniuses. I think that means you're screwed. Let's try this. Accurate. I probably should have said the other thing to see what happens. Alrighty. Well, that's a short one. The broken snake. The first thing that talked. This story has always made me so annoyed. I was totally the kid in Sunday school who pitched a fit over this story. Oh my god, I remember that. You got sent out to adult church to sit with your parents. No punching cookies for me. Wow, I certainly missed out on all that. Oh dude, you didn't even. And it looks like there is one more. What happened then? Is that it for us? Is that it for this story? Up. There we go. Corvin the thief. Stole the diamond from the crown of Rubello, the fire-breathing pope. Caught Errol to death like 200 feet from the palace. So he didn't get to be a consolation for being a great thief then? He did not. Screw the man. Steal their diamonds. Ah yes, the revolutionary zeal of kids from the suburbs. Possum Springs isn't the suburbs. Yeah, you need a city to have suburbs. We're in the dead center of nowhere. It's like a 40-minute drive if you want to buy shoes. Also, I'm 21. I'm not a kid. I think you're younger than me. I'm 21 too. We both have full-time jobs. Well, as close to full-time as they can get. Before they have to start giving us health insurance. I'll be 20 in like 4 months. Hey, so this takes place before the whole events of Night and Woods. Very interesting. Okay, fine. You're all very serious adults. Thank you. Yes, thank you. Wow! Everything's moving so fast! Well, that's all 13 of them. Yay! Thanks, Angus. Ow! is pretty great. You're a big old nerd, Captain. Yes. Yes, I am. You should be a professor. I like to think I fill that role at the video store. Well, I should probably get home. Wait. I just realized that I haven't hung out with you in years, B. What? Yeah, not since like 7th grade? We had a huge fight when we were 12. I remember it more like you stopped sitting with me at lunch, or returning my phone calls, or responding to messages. Always with Greg, too cool for me. Sorry, B. Didn't mean to be a friendship wrecker. It's cool, Greg. It was ages ago. Wait, are we actually in space? But I'm warm and breathing. What am I sitting on? Tyrannosaurus pattern. What? Oh god, I haven't seen Greg or Angus for a year and a half. Regret and emptiness. I didn't go home for longest night. Laundry day. Apple juice taste from when you threw up earlier. You have to call home. You don't want to call home. It's too late to take the bus. What made you think of me today? You don't want to take the bus. This is your new life. Is it still new after a year and a half? Underwear adjust. Next year will be new again. Next year will be new again. Leg stretch. Oh come on, this is getting stupid. Am I serious? What? What's happening here? Well, home's not gonna call itself. Okay. That was interesting.